I'm going to have some corn sprayed. We don't need no stinking point rose.
Oh, these beans look good.
But this farm has caught a couple of rains too that I haven't caught at home. So I think they're probably, well, the one time there was 4 tenths. We got nothing at home, and I don't know, probably half inch ahead. Yeah. Shrinking, but all in all they still look pretty darn good, so I'm not gonna complain. But this hasn't had beans on it for I think 4 years, this spot, so hopefully there'll be some pretty good ones. I don't know if anybody remembers when I was site dressing, I had 4 rows that were screwed up from herbicide damage that I did this spring. And this is them outside rows. Had a few point rows here, so just well winger and get a little bit of corn sprayed. So yeah. The nice thing about this sprayer, you can really get the wings up in the air. Outside 4 rows are a little shorter, but there's gonna be corn there anyways. A couple weeds every once in a while. Back in this corner I got a bunch of vella leaf for some reason. But yeah, we're spraying for we got some loopers, we got some frog eye leaf spot, I think it is. Just getting her done. We always end up having to spray for aphids anyways, and that's the 23rd of July. I've been finding some, not enough to have to spray, but if we're gonna spray fungicide, we gotta get it done here. So just throwing her all together. A lot of people have been spraying corn. I don't really know why. Really no disease or anything out there, so I don't know. The prices, and we need rain. I mean, stuff looks pretty decent on this farm. You can see some of the spots are kind of, I don't know. It isn't terrible, but the lighter ground is bad. This farm's pretty heavy ground, so it's hanging on better than some. Yeah. Really like the sprayer for this type of application. It just color beans and stuff. It's working really good. them little buggers that's putting all these holes in these beans.